What is going on, guys? Thank you for checking out the video. Another beautiful 70 degree day here. I'm pulling up to the art museum here real quick to start because I want to get some cool little shots of the bike, but then we're going to go out, practice some more wheelies, and just rip around. I hope you guys enjoyed that. We are gonna go sort of to our wheelie spot now and go practice some wheelies. It's just such a beautiful day. I'm sure we're gonna run into some other bikers out today. We'll see what we can't find though. Always have wanted to wheelie up this. Wheelie into the art museum. Woo! Ho ho, almost ate it right there. All right, let's keep moving. Ooh, nice Mercedes. Car's sweet, man. I dig it. Yeah. See, I like when people compliment my bike, so I'll return the favor, compliment the car, especially because I like it. It's a bit of a scary looking intersection. Just got people coming head on at you. Woo! DRZ. Going too fast to wheelie. But guys, if you're curious, if you're new to this channel, you're probably wondering what my gearing is on this bike, this 2015 CRF250L. I run 1442 gearing. When I started learning wheelies, I ran 1342. I just moved up to 1442 because for street riding, it's honestly just better. You have a little bit more top end. It's good if I want to hop on the highway or something. So 1442 is what I run. I do have an upgraded clutch rings, the Barnett clutch rings, but that's about it performance-wise. We've got this FMF on here, but no EJK, no ECU flash or anything like that. So guys, with all those mods, this is what I can do. My music is so loud right now, but it's hyping me up. Oh yeah. It's a beautiful Friday night. Gonna rip a little ride, maybe get some drinks after this. Guys, I'm just so glad it's the weekend. I had a very long week at work. Just happened to be out on the bike and have an awesome weekend. Hopefully the weather's nice tomorrow too. Maybe I can ride then. We shall see though, but we're gonna enjoy the right now. This thing loves to cruise now with these new Supermoto wheels. She just loves to cruise. Up to 70, no issue. She'll chill at 70 without a problem. Sheesh! Sky looks nice right now. It's like cotton candy. Yummy. Whew, looks like they're redoing this whole road. Oh my God. Watch out for the sewage covers, or the manhole covers. Watch the loose gravel. Oh. Yeah, guys, I really hope we continue to get a couple of these warmer days as we head into November. Well, I guess we're still in October, but it'd be cool if it stays warm. We can keep riding without having to bundle up. Ooh, I'm interested to see if we can find a cool little spot to take some cinematics of the bike over here. Guys, I am loving this little DJI Pocket 2. It's just so sweet. Like, it's so tiny, and it gets the stable shots that you're going to see in just a second. But here we go. Let's go to the cinematics. All right, guys, let's keep moving. Hopefully there's no nails in that. Whew. Looks like they redid all this too, actually. Very nice. They redid the whole lot just for me and my wheelies. This place really is the best, I gotta say. Still not crazy level, but Guys, one thing I've really been wanting to do recently, I'm sure if you watch like other moto vloggers, Surans, those electric bikes are so popular right now, and I want one of them so damn bad, but they're literally like $4,500. However, I've been watching a lot of Suranster, and he has this whole build with this company called Electro & Co, where they take like a little Razor electric dirt bike that's made to go 14 miles an hour, put a 72-volt battery in it and a controller, and it literally rips and does like 45 miles an hour. I'm very much considering doing something like that. It's like less than half the cost of a Suran. Let me know if you guys have any thoughts on that. I feel like it could be a fun addition to the channel. That doesn't mean I'd get rid of the CRF250L. Obviously, this thing is here to stay. Just got the Supermoto wheels for it after all. But electric bike might be kind of sick. 72-volt little Razor dirt bike. I feel like it would be so fun. Little biker meet. Should we pop in? What's going on? Yeah, yeah. Hold up, sorry, I got my music blaring. Yeah, is that the Duke 200? I saw this. How do you like it? Yeah, I mean, it's scary. It takes a while to learn. Like, I've been practicing for a year. Well, dude, yeah, like, the thing is, like, you gotta be so much farther back than you think you have to be, and it's scary as fuck. Like, you feel like you're gonna fall backwards. So it's terrifying.
I would recommend, like, dude, with that, just go in a parking lot, just practice popping the clutch in first gear, and just, like, tap the rear brake. Yeah, like, you just gotta get, because when you, like, go far back, you just wanna, like, kick yourself off the bike, yeah. So, like, you wanna just get the muscle memory. When I started, I would just go in, like, a parking lot, I'd go back and forth 100 times, just pop it up, hit the rear brake, pop it up, hit the rear brake.
And I'm not even that good yet.
We need that, like, when we ride, you be safe.
Yeah, for sure.
I'll
hit a wheelie out of here for you quick. Found myself a new riding group, guys. I love this. This is what it's all about. Bike life, baby. If I was good enough, I'd wheelie here, but I am not good enough, that's for sure. Woo! Well, guys, that was another Connor G YouTube special on the CRF250L. I'll leave you guys with a little wheelie if traffic permits. Beautiful view of the city. Thank you for watching. Please like, comment, subscribe. I'll catch you next time. Damn you, BMW. Peace.
Gotta go and get it back. Dior, Gucci, Roy, Tusi. She's a movie, but means nothing to me.